papá. Mira, hemos traído esta planta. ¿Le quieres hacer fotos?
I grabbed the camera and the micro lens and went to the living room to see what they had brought. It only took one picture for me to realize that I was going to be spending a lot of time with this plant. It had some really, really small parts that were hard to see clearly with the naked eye. Micro lenses have a very small depth of field, so you're always shooting at high f-stops, which means longer exposures, which means that you have to use a tripod. So, unless I plan to use it, this lens usually stays at home. Another thing to consider before running out to buy a macro lens and a tripod is that in order to take a picture of something that measures only a few millimeters across, both you and your camera are going to have to get so close to your subject that you're probably going to block the light. In that case, you will also have to buy a micro flash or a micro ring light, which, by the way, will reflect off any shiny surface. What I really like about this plant are the nectar glands. Their color and transparency keep changing depending on the angle of the light. During the last 2 weeks, I've spent hours taking pictures of these little guys, and it seems like every day I discover something I hadn't noticed before. Having a macro lens changes the way you see the world. You become obsessed with the little things. Instead of taking pictures of animals, you search for insects. Instead of taking pictures of faces, you take pictures of people's eyeballs. In macro photography, nothing is smooth, sharp, or perfect. Everything is rough, dull, and imperfect. You discover a whole world of textures and patterns that were invisible to you. See you in the next episode.